Thanks for coming, Fight Club. We appreciate it. Today, you know, you're all here for the Q&A. So if you have questions, I would suggest maybe start lining up at the two microphones. We only have a limited amount of time, so if you want to get your question in, definitely line up now. Now, today we have a very special guest for the Q&A. You are fortunate enough to have one of our UFC champions here answering all your questions. So let's take a closer look at the man who's going to answer your questions today.
You know, being successful in this sport opens up a lot of possibilities, and one of the toys I've been wanting to get since I've come into a little more money is a new boat.
What's going on?
What's up, brother?
How are you guys?
Good. Nice. Thanks for having us in.
Yeah, no problem.
This is exciting.
Malibu has always been one of my favorite boat companies, and me and Rebecca got to go and check out some new boats and kind of see what I'm interested in.
So sick.
Sweet, man. I think we've decided this is probably what we want.
Perfect. Heck yeah.
Appreciate it.
Nice. Thanks, man. Good to see you again.
You too.
Yeah. You ready? All right, here we go.
Kind of go out, relax, enjoy some sun, maybe do some wake surfing, check out some houses on the river. You know, it's just so relaxing to be out on the water. It's by far one of my favorite things to do.
All right, let's bring him out here, your UFC bantamweight champion, TJ Dillashaw. TJ, come on out. I like how they're playing your music. Yeah, appreciate that. All right, guys, if you have questions for microphones, nice skills on there. Wake surfing too. World champion wake surfer. That's fine.
Trying it all.
All right, go ahead.
Hey TJ, how's it going?
Going good, man. How about you?
Pretty good, thanks. It's been talked about your relationship with Coach Dwayne Ludwig, and it's also talked about with Duke Rufus and Anthony Pettis, Demetrius Mighty Mouse Johnson, and Matt Hume. If you were giving advice to a young fighter, would that be the first piece of advice you would give him? To develop that kind of relationship with their coach?
Yeah, I mean, that's definitely really important. I'd say to find the right team as well. You know, you need the right people that are going to push you every single day in practice, push you in your lifestyle. You know, so my team, first most, helped me out. You know, Team Alpha Male backed me, kind of showed me the road, showed me what I should be doing, as well as all my life wrestling. You know, they kind of did the same thing. And then to top it off, you got to have a coach you can believe in, you know, cares about you. Surrounding yourself by the right people is probably one of the most important things you can do.
All right.
Master Spinter.
Can I just say congratulations to Megan and Jiu-Jitsu for getting engaged?
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Right.
We'll switch sides.
Oh, thank you very much. Hey, TJ, just real quick, can you talk about your journey from the beginning of The Ultimate Fighter all the way till, I guess you could even say today, as far as winning the belt and your experiences during that time, what it's meant for you personally, but as well as your family?
Question.
Yeah, I mean, it's been a fast rise. It's been real crazy, you know. Even just getting into The Ultimate Fighter, I'd only been fighting for a year, and I had to do a lot of learning really quick, and the best way to do that was just kind of learning from your losses and learning from your mistakes throughout The Ultimate Fighter, and just kind of pushing through those things, and I mean, it really just came from the belief of just knowing that I was doing the right things, you know, and learning from my mistakes. It meant everything to me to win the belt, obviously. I mean, losing Ultimate Fighter was kind of rough, and then I think that's what motivated me to get right back in the octagon instantly and push through those next couple fights and just strive to be the best, man. I mean, it was the ultimate goal.
Well, congratulations. This might be my 10-year-old daughter's first UFC fight. Do you mind if we come up and take a picture with you by chance?
Oh, no problem.
Is that
that's
possible?
Awesome, yeah.
Can
yeah.
you wait till the end? We'll,
yes.
We'll have them make sure that you can
Excellent.
Come over. Thanks.
You're coming for a great card for your first one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Getting spoiled.
You excited? Turning red. Sorry, we'll stop.
If there was one person you could fight in an open weight pride rules fight, who would you fight?
Man, I don't know. Someone that's active now?
Doesn't matter.
That's a tough question.
That is a tough question.
There's too many people to choose from. I'd probably go someone like Struve, just because he's so tall and I'm, you know, short. It'd just be a funny fight. You know, it'd be like the most awkward thing ever.
Thank you.
I'd pick Struve.
Who would you have him fight?
Minnowoman.
It's up to you.
Minnowoman.
Oh, I thought you said man or woman.
Yeah,
I was like, it's up to
that's
you.
Sort of a, oh, okay.
Okay, fair enough. Nice.
All right, TJ. I think most people assume that your next fight would be against Dominic Cruz. However, that hasn't been signed yet.
That's the plan.
We also heard you say that you really would like to fight Jose Aldo someday. Is the fact that it hasn't been signed, the Dominic Cruz fight not been signed, does that have anything to do with waiting for the outcome of the Aldo Mendez fight, or is it something completely different that we haven't seen yet?
No, that was just me watching Mendez and Aldo fight and just thinking that I could beat him. You know, I was just thinking that I've seen some holes in his game that I feel like I can take advantage of, and that'd be a great fight for me. So just kind of voiced my opinion about that.
Are you voicing that to Dana and everybody else, or are you just voicing it to the public?
I feel like I need to defend my belt, be a little more, be dominant in my weight class before I can even think about going to another weight class and, you know, getting another belt. But I'll continue to voice it as long as he's there holding on to it.
And can we expect to hear an announcement about your upcoming fight anytime soon?
You know, that's not up to me. You know, I mean, I don't know the date, but I'll definitely be fighting Dominic Cruz, and that's something I want. You know, that's the fight I want, and I'm pretty sure it's a fight the fans want. So we'll wait for the date.
All right, thank you. Yeah.
I'm going to ask you a question. Your teammate, your IFA, fought Dominic Cruz. How much did you help in that preparation? Did you emulate Dominic while Uriah was training for him? So do you kind of already have a sense of what to do in there?
Absolutely. I've had a game plan for him for a while now because of the fact of helping Uriah push through for his two camps and fighting Dominic Cruz and things that I would have done differently for him in that fight. So kind of the same aspect of me getting Uriah ready for Henry Burrell is the same thing I did earlier in my career for Dominic Cruz.
Sure.
So I do have a great idea of what I'm going to do, and I've learned a lot from him for my own style as well.
Yeah, that's going to be a really fun fight. Can't
awesome.
Wait.
Thanks. Hey, TJ, congratulations on your title.
Thank you.
Great. My question is this. Now that you've reached the top of your division, how do you keep separating yourself from those? You know, what I'm looking at is a lot of people make it to the top, and they forget how they get there.
Yeah.
And then they just stop. How do you separate?
I feel like you can't lose the hunger to be the best. You know, I mean, you got to know that there's always someone really good coming up behind you. There's myself chasing me down. You know, so I got to know that someone's looking for my belt. I got a target on my back, and to prove that I'm still the best in the world, and that I'm going to work harder than the person that's below me.
Awesome, man. Good, great luck.
I appreciate that. Thank you.
Do you feel like people call you out more that you're the champ?
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, like I said, I got a target on my back now. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, before it was just I was on the rise. You know, you don't want to fight a guy that's on the rise. You'd rather fight the best.
Yeah, absolutely. Go
ahead. Hey, buddy.
How's it going?
Number one, I'm glad you're married now, yeah, because my wife is in love with you. Number two, what's your take on the missing of the weight and the Henry Burrell thing when he fell out? And number three, are you wanting to fight him again? Yeah, because there's a lot of talk of he was this, he was that, blah, 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 blah.
I mean, my first thought when that happened was that he didn't want to fight me. You know, I felt it in his countdown shows, just kind of seeing it, and the fact that the fight would happen so quickly, and I feel like his coaches wanted it more than he did. You know, but who knows? He's a really big guy, cuts a lot of weight. You know, he might need to figure out how to get a better nutritionist or whatever. I don't know. It's tough to really know what happened, you know. And obviously he's going to win a couple fights if he gets back at it. And I'd love to fight him again, give him another chance.
Yeah,
prove that it wasn't a fluke.
Yeah, just because of his dominance for so long in that division, right?
Yeah, I feel like he's got some wins to make up, though. You know, he can't just come in off of what he's done and the way that I beat him. You know, I didn't even agree with the rematch completely, but I knew that he was a tough guy, so I gave him a shot.
For sure, know? When you dominate somebody like that, that's for sure.
Yeah, process. Absolutely.
Okay, perfect.
Thank you.
Hey, TJ.
How's it going?
Hey, I want to know what your thoughts were on the Reebok signing.
Ooh, good one.
Yeah, I think it's actually a pretty good deal. I mean, Reebok's an awesome company that's going to be taking over. It's going to take a lot of stress off me trying to find a sponsor for my fights. I'm in a good position, you know, being where I'm at now, too, for being with Reebok. I feel like it's just going to make our sport look a little more professional. You know, everyone's wearing the same kind of stuff. We have designated T-shirts, and it's just going to, you know, be more like the NBA, more like the NFL, just kind of brand our sport a little bit more. So I'm all for it.
All right. Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
Good.
Hey, you both fight at 135.
Me and TJ, yes.
Yes.
Yeah. That's the one I was looking for. No, I was thinking you and Uriah Faber.
Yeah.
Who would win in thumb wrestling?
That's tough, dude. We've been practicing our skills on TAM radio, so it's been tough. Carlino's actually the champ right now. It's Sir Studboy, as you might know him on TAM radio. So I just lost him the other night. But I'm going to have to pick myself.
Yeah, you gotta have confidence in yourself.
Got to be confident.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, number two, my little brother is actually missing this because he's in route. Yeah. Would you mind just saying, what's up, John?
What's his name?
John Glancy. We need John Glancy.
John Glancy. I hate John Glancy. Sorry you had to miss out, but see you next time.
Thanks, TJ.
Cool.
What a champ. Nice work. Yeah.
Hey, TJ, for your style against Dominic Cruz, what do you believe is your best weapon, and what do you believe is his best weapon against you?
You know, I feel like he's an opponent that's kind of hard to catch. He's used his elusiveness to not get hit and to be able to tag and move and work his way towards a decision. And I think the problem with me is that I'm able to cut him off with certain angles and that I'm a little bit more aggressive than he is. We're both very well-rounded, but I feel like just my aggressiveness and my will to finish the fight is going to be the deciding factor in this one.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
Again, can't wait for that fight.
For your first title fight, you were quite an underdog, to say the least. Mm-hmm. Does that get to you? Do people, you know, even Joe Rogan kind of had to talk you up as this is a legitimate contender. Does that go into the fight? Do you guys, you know, the odds are on the TV. Do you ever think about, wow, people think I have no chance, and does that inspire you, or does that kind of worry you?
You know, a little bit of both. I mean, you definitely get inspired by it. You know, you're getting a chance to beat a guy that's supposedly unbeatable, you know, and so you kind of rise to the occasion and just, like I said, almost believe in yourself. But you also got to be worried. The guy's dangerous. You know, he's ranked that high, and he's that much of a favorite for a reason. Hadn't lost in ever, you know. So being worried is also the reason why I won. You know, if I was going in there too confident, I would have got beat. You know, so there's a fine line of being too confident, and you got to be worried as well.
Well, on behalf of people like myself who bet on you, thanks. It was a good payout.
Awesome. Thank you.
You want some cash that night. Yeah.
So, TJ.
How's it going?
Hey, who are your picks for tomorrow's main fights and why? The two main fights.
Okay.
Pettis versus Melendez first. We'll go.
Okay, Pettis versus Melendez. I'm going to pick Pettis. I feel like he's a little bit too technical for him. You know, Melendez is tough. He's going to bring the fight to him. He's going to brawl with him. But I think Pettis is going to pull it out with just being too slick. You know, his kickboxing is awesome. I like his footwork. So I think he's going to end up finishing the fight as well. Hendricks and Lawler, I'm picking Hendricks on his wrestling. I feel like it's going to be a different fight this time. I feel like he's going to come out and use his wrestling to his advantage. You know, he saw that it won it for him in the fifth round, and that hopefully he'll use it a little bit differently this time. Not stand in front of Lawler and beat him at his own game and use his strength.
Cool.
Yeah.
Quick shout out to Team Alpha Male Radio.
Absolutely.
Good stuff. One of the best podcasts.
Someone pay you to
going
to
on fan. Out here. TJ, I really respect you as a fighter and a person.
I appreciate that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thank you.
What's the one thing that would hold you back from fighting Uriah?
The fact that he's the one that actually even got me into the sport. He's the one that talked me into even fighting. I was going to go to grad school, try to become a physician's assistant, graduated college in wrestling, and I met Uriah at a wrestling camp, and he, you know, remember me, tried to recruit me to wrestle at Davis where he was coaching, and you know, talked me into it, saying that I was a tough wrestler, was real aggressive, would be a good fighter, and that I should give it a shot. Moved into his house into Sacramento, and he just kind of showed me the way. You know, it'd be tough for me to, because I believe in myself, I would beat Uriah if I fought him, you know. But the fact is, I would never want to do that. You know, I wouldn't want to beat a guy that brought me into the sport and show me the way, and just kind of also the way to live my life. You know, he leads by example. He's a great guy. I would just never want to do that. Fighting your best friend would never be fun.
But you could see it happening if you pass Dom.
What's that?
You could see it happening if you pass Dom.
We don't want to do it. You know, we don't want to have to.
There's still guys like Rafael.
Yeah, so you know, I still got some fights ahead of me, and you know, we'll deal with it when it comes. But I hope not. I hope we don't have to deal with that.
Good answer.
Thank you.
Oh, hello. First fight.
Yeah. What's Who's your name?
Madeline.
Nice to meet you.
Who's your favorite fighter?
Favorite fighter, that's tough. There's a lot of good ones. Just because of his raw emotion and the way he fights, I'm about to pick Nick Diaz. Yeah, I've always been a Diaz fan. He brings everything to the cage. And I'm from the same – he's repping 209. I'm from 209, so I got to stick with my boy. And thank you. Good question.
Lots of Diaz fans here. Hi.
My name's Jillian. I was just wondering, today's my 14th birthday, and I'm a really big fan. Do you think afterwards we could take a picture?
Absolutely, and happy birthday.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Hey, I read an article recently, and Dana discussed the possibility of paying the fighters based on where they're ranked. You know, the top fighter obviously gets the most money and down from there. Do you think that's a good idea, and why or why not?
Yeah, I haven't heard anything about that, but why not? I love it. I'm the champ. Let's pay
that.
Me.
I read that this morning.
I think
so,
you're talking about the Reebok deal, where you said the champions will be on one pay scale, then 1 through 5, then 6 through 10.
Exactly,
11
yeah.
through 15.
And
yeah.
and just based on Dana getting a group of people to, you know, rank the fighters differently now, where there's a bunch of, you know, people that do it.
Yeah,
it
seems, currently it's journalists. It's MMA journalists who vote on the rankings every week. But
she knows. I have no idea.
But I think they're going to make the group smaller.
Yeah,
more
that's
prestigious,
what, yeah.
from what I'm told.
But, I agree with it. I mean, why not pay the best? You know, I mean, it seems the most fair. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You'd make out pretty well, I think. Champion TJ
Dillashaw.
Right. He'll get paid all right.
Chance,
thank you.
So, TJ, upon his return, John Dotson showed interest in fighting you. Is that a fight you want to take part of to get some revenge or something?
You know, I would definitely wouldn't mind fighting the guy down the road, but I feel like he'd have to even prove himself at 135s before he'd even get a shot at me. You know, he lost his shot at 125s at the belt, and obviously he wants to say that he'd fight me because he beat me before. But for one, that was a fluke, and two, I'm a completely different fighter, so I'd say bring it on.
For sure, man.
Yeah, do you ever look at how much your game's evolved since that fight with John Dotson in the finale?
Oh, it's funny. You don't really look at it until you have to look at through some old highlights and some of your old fights, and you just kind of forget the progress you've made until you look back on some of those fights. And it's crazy to see the rise I've made in the last year and a half, 2 years. So
yeah, crazy.
Yeah. I don't know what side. I think we're over here. Oh, no? Okay.
Hey, TJ, one more.
No problem.
Hey, how do you develop your killer instinct, especially when you're in that ring where you show no fear? I mean, is that something you had coming up, or is it just how did that come about?
Killashaw.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I was just raised that way. My family's super competitive. I got All two right. brothers. I'm a middle child, and just kind of feel like I was raised to be competitive, and just I hate losing more than I even like winning. So it kind of brings it out in you, and you gotta just lose the fear. The process of competing through wrestling, it just kind of teaches you that, you know, teaches you to forget about all the bad things that can happen and just believe in yourself. And then after that, it's just, you know, turns into competitiveness and makes me aggressive.
Have one more. And when you see, I wouldn't even say the word failure, but how do you see when you do mistake? Do you just build on them, or there's no such thing as failure in what you do?
Yeah, you definitely got to build off your losses and the things that you've done wrong. You can't look back on it as a failure. There's a reason. I believe that there's a reason why it happened, and the reason why, for me, that I need to get better. You know, you have to learn from your losses. I mean, everyone always says it, but it's the truth.
Right on, man.
Yep.
I want to go back to this competitiveness from your brothers.
Yeah.
I saw you, I think you Instagrammed a photo of, like, a beautiful sunset. And instead of saying something about that, you're like, great day to kick my brother's butt in golf, right? Yeah. Like, you can't even let him win in golf. You're a world champion.
Yeah,
you
no matter
beat
what
him
it
in
is.
Everything.
Yeah, I mean, I remember my little brother beat me in video games, and I would get pissed and try beating him up. So he ended up just, like, letting me win so I wouldn't get mad and get angry at him. So we've been competitive our entire lives. So I got very athletic brothers that have, you know, always kept me on my game. So
yeah.
It definitely works.
So, speaking of Diaz, how do you picture the fight with Anderson Silva going?
I think it's going to be a great fight. I'm interested to see how Silva's going to come back. And I always love watching Diaz fight. He brings it every time. And I think it's going to be a great fight.
If, like, how do you picture if Diaz does win, how do you picture him getting the victory?
I think with his constant pressure, you know, that's one thing that Diaz does. He never lets you rest. He's kind of always peppering you with his jab, touching his punches, always kind of on you. He doesn't get tired because he's not throwing big power shots, and then he picks his hard shots. You know, I feel that he brings his feet with him just like Wyman does, and that's how he caught Silva to begin with. And you know, if I see him winning, he's going to outbox him with his pressure.
Cool. Thanks, CJ.
Yep.
Hey, TJ.
How's it going?
Not too bad. What's your view on Conor McGregor?
You're not from Ireland or anything, right?
Yeah.
I know, I feel like he's done a very good job promoting himself. He's a great fighter. He's even a better talker. You know, it's got him in a great position right now, and I feel like he's going to get a shot at the title even quicker than he even deserves. But we're going to see how it goes.
Okay. Yep. Thanks.
No problem.
You've got a teammate in Conor's division, Chad Mendes. How do you see a fight between Chad and Conor going down?
I would love to see that fight. I feel like Chad would tear him up. You know, I feel like that's one of Conor's weaknesses is that is the wrestling. You know, I put him on his back, and I don't feel like he's going to win the fight, and Mendez can definitely do that.
Yeah. Hey, what's going on, TJ?
Going good. How about you?
Good. First off, I want to say that Hennen Burrell, you just totally dominate him. Absolutely. I think a lot of people are caught off guard with that. Just dominated the whole fight.
Yep.
With that being said, who do you think would be a tougher rematch, him or Joe Soto?
I feel like Burrell's more dangerous, and I'd probably Burrell. I'd pick Burrell. You know, I mean, I only got a day to prepare for Joe Soto. It was kind of a tough game plan going into it. I knew he was a good grappler. I practiced with him a lot, and he was a good wrestler. So I had to switch some things up last minute that I wasn't too sure of. So I feel like I could have done even better in that fight if I'd had more time to prepare for Joe, and that Burrell would probably be the harder rematch.
Well, with that being said, do you feel like Joe would have done better if he had time to prepare as well? And then also, when you did train with him, how did it go?
No, I feel like I would have got the better one if we'd have had more time to train for the fight. Training with him was good. Taking the fight was hard for me because I knew how tough he was. You know, no one else knew how tough he was except for me and the guys that paid attention to Bellator. Wrestled with him in high school, state champ. He came up and grappled with me like I think 8 weeks before our fight, and we wrestled for 45 minutes straight. No one could take each other down, so I knew that he had some good grappling skills and that he was a tough wrestler. It was like I said, it was a nerve-wracking situation I was put in.
Sounds good. Appreciate it.
And no problem.
Hey, what's up again, TJ? Uriah made the decision to go with Martin Kampman as the striking coach after he parted ways with Dwayne Ludwig. Mm-hmm. Do you ever work with Kampman, and is the vibe awkward in there when he's there, knowing you have a great relationship with Dwayne Ludwig?
Not at all. Kampman's fit in perfectly with our team. You know, the reason why we picked Kampman is because he's kind of been there, done that. He's been in the UFC. He's well-rounded. He's a great striker. You know, mine and Dwayne's relationship doesn't affect anything that me and Kampman have going on. Kampman runs all of our pro practices, and I've participated in them. And, you know, he's a great coach. He has a great eye for MMA.
All right. Thank you.
Yep.
Well, this is where I'm going to ask a question now. Dwayne Ludwig moved to Colorado. He's opened his own gym. Obviously, he came back for your last camp. Do you see him doing that again, or are you going to spend more time in Colorado? How do you see the next camp playing out?
Definitely have to probably spend some time in Colorado. I even want to do so before I even get into camp. But, you know, I'm hoping I can kidnap him for 8 weeks. You know, I told him that I'm adding on to my house so that he can move him and his family out for 8 weeks, and that you know, I need him for my camp, so I'm hoping it works.
Yeah.
And I'll never let him leave.
It's me again. What's your take on Frankie Edgar? I mean, he just went in there and mopped Cub Swanson up. I mean, 5 rounds, just beat him down and then submitted him. And everybody's overlooking him. It's like, dude, wait a minute. Frankie's getting shafted everywhere.
Frankie looked really good. I liked how aggressive he looked coming out in the fight and used his ground and pound to a perfection. You know, we haven't seen much of that out of him. You've always seen his great boxing, his good footwork, and it was nice to see him kind of change it up. I don't think anybody's looking over him. It's just that weight class is stacked, man.
Yeah, well, shouldn't it be Frankie Edgar and McGregor before?
Absolutely. I think McGregor should have to fight someone other than Seaver before he gets his title fight. You know, I think Frankie Edgar's a good fight for him as well, yeah.
I want to take this time to publicly ask you this because I know you've had a little bit of a problem with it. Somebody on a website has that your official nickname is the Viper.
Yeah.
Can we just say right now that that's not true?
It's been something that's haunted me for the last couple years. Yeah, after I got off the Ultimate Fighter, somehow someone put my nickname on the internet. I think it was on SureDog. Someone added it on there, and ever since then, every now and then I'll get the random fan or the reporter that asked me about my nickname, and it's. I always got to tell them the story that it's not...
It's not real at all.
It's not real. I have a lot of nicknames given to me in the gym, but the Viper's not one of them.
Yeah, no. What would be your nickname if you could pick? Because you do have a lot.
Out of all the ones, I think I'd have to stick with the first one ever given to me, and that was when Uriah called me Lieutenant Dan. Because
John Morgan likes it. If John Morgan likes it, it's done.
I got to the gym, and I knew nothing about boxing or sparring whatsoever, and I think I was sparring either Joseph or... Another tough kid that was in our gym, and I went in there with zero skills and was just swinging at the fences, bleeding out my nose and my mouth because I was getting tagged up, and just super angry that I wasn't doing better, and just yelling at the kid to bring it harder at me. And ever since the day, Uriah's been calling me Lieutenant Dan when he yells at the storm when he's on the ship, you know, telling God to bring it on. And that's probably the name I'd have to stick with.
Can we get Buffer to announce that? That would be great.
It would be completely random. It would be funny.
I might have to write it in on his card next time you fight.
Oh, me? Okay. Yeah. What's up, TJ?
What's going
Much
on?
Respect to you, bro.
I appreciate it.
My question is, with Uriah recruiting you to join, do mixed martial arts, have you recruited anybody of your from high school or college to join Team Alpha Male so they can start getting their name recognition in the cage or anything like that?
I wouldn't say that I've recruited anybody, but I might have influenced people to come to our gym. I got a buddy, Nick Jordan, right now that's working out with Team Alpha Male, and he wrestled with me at college at Fullerton. Mm-hmm. So he's up training with us now. You know, I didn't give him a call and tell him he should move up there, but just kind of my success and the way that Team Alpha Male works, I feel like what we do is we kind of just lead by example, and people are like-minded people are kind of influenced to train with us.
Okay, thanks.
Yep, no problem.
That was a good question.
Let's just say that Connor does get the title shot against Jose Aldo.
Yeah.
Has Uriah shown interest in fighting Frankie Edgar? Because I remember that was discussed for The Ultimate Fighter when Frankie Edgar was one of the coaches.
I remember there being a little bit of talk about it. I'm sure he'd be down for it. It'd be an awesome fight. I'd love to see it. It'd be a great super fight. So,
less weight for him to cut.
Yeah, exactly. He's a big guy as well. He looks huge when he's in the octagon, so it'd be easy for him to go 45s again. But who knows? We'll see.
Oh, and also, Team Alpha Male is known for their lighter weight fighters. Have you guys been recruiting any, you know, heavier weight fighters?
We do have heavier weight fighters in our gym. We got some good ones. It's just the fact of them breaking through. You know, it's a tough process to break through and get into the UFC. And we're stacked in the lower weight classes, and that's where all our great sparring partners are. So by us pushing each other, I think that's the reason why we've climbed so fast. We need to do the same thing for our heavier weight guys. But I think we'd have to create two practices. You know, we have too many guys as it is, and we're already falling on top of each other. So, you know, if we had a heavier weight alpha male, we'd have to, like I said, create an A and a B team. Obviously, the smaller guys would be A, right?
Yeah, right, exactly.
I heard Uriah trying to recruit Brendan Schaub the other day.
He needs to. Brendan Schaub's just a big alpha male. He's a big, big little alpha male, if it makes sense.
What are your thoughts on talk about Brock Lesnar coming back?
I haven't even heard about that.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. I feel like he's tried. He's done it and he's tried. I don't know if it's a good idea. You know, just by watching the way he kind of cowers from getting hit, I don't know if it's in his best interest to come back.
Do you think he should train at Alpha Male then?
I don't think he'd fit in there, man. I don't think we'd have anybody for him to train with at all.
Thank you.
I want to
take like three of us to spar that guy.
I want to go back to that last question. Why are you guys so successful as a team, and why do you guys get along? We see so many different teams, and you know everybody gets along, but they might not necessarily think of each other as family. Why is Alpha Male different?
Like I said, like-minded people were just attracted to our team. We didn't recruit too much. You know, Joseph Benavides just kind of showed up to the gym, and Uriah told him to stay. You know, it wasn't the fact that Uriah called Joseph and told him to come to the gym. It was just kind of Joseph showed up, liked it, got along with everyone, and stayed there. And that's kind of happened with each one of the fighters at our gym. And, you know, when you get a bunch of people around that think exactly the same, you're going to start becoming best friends, turn into, like you said, turn into a little family. And when you have that much care for your teammate, you're going to help. You're going to do whatever you can to help him for his next fight and to help him be successful. So that's, I feel like, our biggest strength with our team is just our unity. We want to help each other out.
Yeah, and it's working out. I mean, you have guys, younger guys like Chris Holdsworth and Andre Feely, and then just signed Cody.
Cody Nola.
Yeah, so he fights in January. So there's got to be a secret to the success, though. You keep signing people right out of that camp.
I don't know what it is. I'm not really sure. It's just if you're in there sparring every day with the top guys in the world, you're going to get better. And if you don't, you're going to get beat up and probably leave, you know? Mm-hmm. So it's just kind of the fact that if you can hang, you're going to stick around, you're going to continue to get better. And, you know, we got eight guys in the UFC now, and all of them are 155s and below.
Yeah, crazy. You do need some bigger guys.
We do. We do.
Go ahead.
Hi, TJ. My name is Susie.
Nice to meet you.
And I come from Monterey, California, with two of my good friends.
Awesome.
Hello,
and
friends.
And they're big UFC fans.
All right.
And I only got into UFC because of them too. Now,
well, thank you for getting her into it. Now we got another
fan. And no
fan.
Tickets. I don't have tickets yet for today's fight, so I'm going to go out there and try to get tickets. Okay. But I'm looking forward to your fight with Cruz.
I appreciate that.
So I want to make sure that you're going to kick his butt,
absolutely.
First of all. And second of all, what are you doing to prepare yourself for it?
Oh, you know, right now I'm not even in camp, so it's just the fact of getting better. Finding holes in my own game by watching tape on myself, having Dwayne pick me apart, and just making sure that I'm getting stronger in the areas that I have a little bit of weaknesses in. Because everyone's got them. You know, you just got to kind of fill in the holes a little bit.
we still think you still have a little bit of an advantage because Cruz is just coming back. And he doesn't realize who he's fighting.
And just because of the fact I'm better.
Exactly. Thank you.
When you would watch Dominic Cruz before the injury, was there ever a thought in your mind, like, I know I'm going to fight this guy?
I mean, it was kind of a wish, you know. I mean, when I first got into MMA, he was the champion. And I hadn't even had a fight yet, you know. And Uriah was getting ready to fight Cruz. And so it was always like that was the goal, was to get there.
Yeah.
I mean, I started to believe in myself once the process was happening. But it was too far out to picture me fighting him. But like I said, it was always a goal of mine to fight Dominic. And so that's why I'm so pumped on this fight. That, you know, someone that I've kind of got into the sport watching and being the best, I actually get my chance to beat him.
Yeah, definitely. Now, you've taken a little bit of time off since your last fight.
Yeah.
What have you been doing?
Just getting big. I'm way too big right now. I've been doing nothing but lifting
eating
weights.
Everything.
Yeah, the holidays were horrible on me. But I had elbow surgery like 5 weeks ago, so I haven't been able to get back to full practices yet. Starting to get back in shape and, you know, getting out on the river, throwing on the wetsuit and doing some more wake surfing. That's
that
about
boat
it.
That we saw.
Yeah.
How was the elbow? What was it? A minor surgery?
I had a bursitis in my left elbow. It's been happening in my last three camps. Just kind of get fluid on that joint to protect it. And usually I would drain it, it would go away. But I drained it 4 times after my Soto fight. I elbowed him, and I remember it exploded after that. And it was really big. And I drained it 4 different times. It kept coming back, so they had to surgically remove my bursa sac, which the scar looks gnarly, but it was kind of a minor surgery. You know, I'm almost back to full goes, and it's only been 5 weeks, so.
When do you expect to be able to train fully?
I'd say in a couple weeks.
Nice.
You know, 2 weeks, I'd probably be ready to get back in there, start rolling.
So after you eat everything for Christmas, you can go in there, get back in shape.
Get through the holidays, get back in shape, exactly.
Nice. Go ahead.
Hey, I was wondering, have you had any chances to go hunting on your time off? What are some areas you hunt?
I did do a little bit of deer hunting back home. Unfortunately, didn't get anything. I was planning an out-of-state trip, but my back-to-back fights didn't help out with that. I had to get right back into camp, so I didn't get to get into archery season like I usually do this year. So, unfortunately, I haven't done too much hunting.
All right, cool.
Yep.
You use a bow and arrow to hunt?
I do.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, it's so much more fun. Yeah, it's
so
more of a challenge. It's a lot more work, and it makes you appreciate hunting a lot more.
Do you and Chad Mendez hunt together?
We do, yeah. Chad's a little bit more addicted to it than I am. He's probably actually hunting right now as we speak.
Most likely.
Yeah, absolutely. but we've done a few hunting trips together. It's always a good time.
Yeah, that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
Real quick question. I'm not sure how familiar you are with the Tommy Toehold show.
Oh, yeah.
Love him.
So, 3-piece question. Are you still afraid of the dark? Why is Joe so mean to you? And after we're done here, do you want to go get some Sketty?
Love Sketty. I'll go to eat Sketty anytime you want. What was the second one? Why is Joe so mean to
you? Why is Joe so mean to you?
Oh.
I don't know, man, because he got deep love for me. I don't know why he's so mean with me on Tommy Toehold. You know, maybe he's a little bit jealous. I'm not sure. He's over there sitting by my wife. Well, he's got a fiance up here, so I'm not sure what's going on. First question, I missed it too.
Are you still afraid of the dark?
Of course. Yeah, always got to have a nightlight on. You know
Thanks.
How it is. Yep.
That would be great if you really did. Your wife has to leave a light on for you.
Yeah,
champ,
before
scared
she
of
comes
dark.
To bed, she has to leave the closet light on and crack the door because I'm scared of the dark.
Newlywed. How is life?
It's the same.
Same.
You know, yeah. Busy. Been on the road nonstop, but been enjoying it. Obviously can't complain.
They're two cute dogs.
Yeah. Honey Bunny and Cash.
If you guys have questions, make sure you get in line for these two microphones. TJ's only got a couple more minutes before we have to wrap this up.
And thank you for coming out, too.
Yeah, appreciate we it. Love Fight Club.
Yeah.
All right, well, talk to me about how you see Uriah Faber's fight going down with Francisco Rivera tomorrow.
I feel like this is a good fight for Uriah. You know, I don't want to give away too much of how I see it's going to go down, but I definitely see Uriah finishing the fight. He's very aggressive, always pushing the pace, always coming in shape, and he's just going to – I think he's going to outclass him. You know, he's just a little bit too good for Francisco Rivera, and he's going to make quick work of him.
Yeah, and have you been in the gym, even though you've been injured, have you been able to watch practice at least if you can't participate?
Absolutely, yeah. I've been there as much as I possibly can without, you know, obviously I've been traveling a lot, doing a lot of appearances and stuff, but whenever I'm there, I'm running the kickboxing classes, I'm helping out with sparring, I'm watching Campman run the morning pro practice, so staying as active as I can, because if I don't, I'm going to lose my mind.
Yeah.
You know, I can't just sit back and do nothing.
Yeah, do you watch all the fights? We've had a lot of cards lately. We saw you in Austin. Are you a guy that likes to see every single UFC fight?
I'd say it's kind of hard to watch every single one of them because they're on every weekend. But the fact that I'll watch him whenever I can. You know, I'm a huge fan of fighting. Been watching fighting forever, even before I even got involved in it. So anytime I get a chance, love to be front row watching him.
Yeah, we love to see you there. All right, TJ, unfortunately, has to wrap it up now. He's got other commitments. But thank you so much for talking to us today, answering all these fans' questions. Fight Club, you're the best. We appreciate it.
Thanks for showing up, guys. Appreciate it.
I'll be back in a few minutes. Thanks, guys.